two things again. If you claim that you're a consumer-centric organization, diversity is mandatory because you advertise to a diverse community. So that is, if you claim to be consumer-centric, that's one thing you need to have. Secondly, when you claim that you're a professional sports team, not everybody is a defender, not everybody is an attacker, not everybody is a midfield player. So you need, again, also diversity in your team in order to build such a team. For me personally, this is something that almost comes natural. If I look at the teams that I've built throughout my career at ABI and now at Fluent, it's because I have this mindset of building a team that wins with consumers. By default, we get to an extremely diverse team, diversified team. So to give you an idea, I gave a presentation to some New York-based analysts last year in December. And I actually showed my executive team in one of the slides. Not even thinking about it, just for you guys to know, I have five people on my executive team, three of which are women, and two are men. And then they still also have, I have four different nationalities amongst the five people. And I didn't even think about when I put up the slides, because I just wanted them to know who my executive team was. And one of the analysts, after I ended my presentation, stood up and applauded. And she said, I'm not applauding Fluent because of the business results you guys are setting or the business strategy that you guys have, but for the fact that for the first time, I see from the start diversity ingrained into the organization, which I took as an enormous compliment, but I wasn't even going for that one. But what I think is very important also with diversity and inclusion is that people forget about the inclusion piece. Because there's a lot of people who now are putting quotas and positive discrimination and all of those elements in place. I don't believe a policy can fix diversity and inclusion, but especially inclusion. When you have a diverse workforce, how do you make sure everybody's point of view is heard and respected in the final decision? And so that inclusivity piece, I think, is the one that is most often forgotten in the entire diversity, in the entire diversity debate. And I think that deserves more attention. And the way we do it at Fluent is that a meeting will never end when we have heard everybody's point of view, and we appoint sometimes people in the room to say, okay, you pay attention to who speaks and who didn't, and let's make sure that those people's opinion are heard at a later stage.